Hello and welcome to today's session on Certo Virtual Replication 5.0 and how to failover test a VM into the Azure Cloud. The first thing we need to do is run a Certo Cloud appliance inside Azure. So you need a subscription and then you can install Certo Cloud appliance on the Azure portal. We have a marketplace application running, so you can just download it from there and install it to a Windows VM in Azure. And then we have all the resource groups, networking and storage, and also the firewalls which we need to connect to our on-premise environment. Once this is done, we have a Certo Virtual Manager running inside Azure and also one in the local on-premise data center in Hamburg. We see a list of virtual protection groups I've created already, and you find the Ubuntu web server Azure VPG here going into the Azure site in Amsterdam. So how about the settings? The most important ones are here in the recovery tab. So you specify the VNets, basically the networking section in Azure, where we have specified a subnet and also a network security group, which means a firewall. We have set up a couple of rules to access the sites. And also there's the instance family and instance size, which means how big are the failover VMs created in Azure. So we decided to use an A-series VM type, which means in that case we have one CPU and 2 gigabytes of RAM available for that failover VM, and we can change it if we want. Also in the advanced VM settings, we find the IP addresses, which we can change to use the ones specific to my subnets in Azure. So that's all we need to do the failover. And I select test failover here, and in the next screen, I choose the VPG I want to do. So it's this one. I can also select a checkpoint. As you can see, we're creating new checkpoints every 5 seconds in that case. So that means it's very, very granular to go back to any point in time. We just select this one here now and say next. And it says we're ready to do a failover test. So let's do it. What will happen now is we have already replicated the disks from that Ubuntu web server into the Azure site. It is there, it's constantly upgrading the checkpoints, and now we just need to connect those replicated disks with a newly created VM inside the Azure portal. So I switch to my Azure site here, and inside the virtual machine list in the portal, there will soon be a new VM called Ubuntu Web Server Testing Recovery. So let's wait for this to appear. So we found the VM now. It is still in the phase of powering up. So that needs some time because we just create a new virtual machine. It has not been there before. So now all the resources must be pulled together. This can take up to maybe 5 or 10 minutes, depending on the size of the VM and the amount of VMs you have in one VPG. So let's wait for this to finish. So now we see the failover test has been finished. So the VM is up and running now inside Azure, and it could be accessed and productively used. Or in our case, as it is a test failover, we can now log into the VM and do our verification that this VM is in a good state. And once we confirmed this, we just go back into the Certo Virtual Manager, and there we stop the failover test. And we can also select if it was successful and have some notes on it. And now it will shut down and decommission the VM in Azure so that it is no longer used and there's no more compute resources required. And the good thing about this is, you see, it's been done in just a couple of minutes, and you only pay for what you use. So during the year, you just replicate into the cheap storage inside the cloud. And only if there's really a disaster or you want to do some disaster recovery tests, then you need to spin on VMs in the cloud. Otherwise, you just pay for the amount of storage you're consuming. So that makes it very easy and very affordable to have DR in place. And as you can see, Zerto is a very simplistic tool to get the best results and get your stuff focused on the real important things, which is running your IT business. Thank you for watching this video, and stay tuned for others to come. Goodbye.